Hi, this is Manansal V. In this LumaFusion tutorial, I'll show you how to create the cutout animation that you just watched using the functionality added in iOS 16 and iPadOS 16 to lift the subject of a photo from the background. The video simulates an intro for a TV show called Mark and Paula Disagree. The animation goes by pretty fast, so let's take a closer look. As Mark and Paula turn around and face each other, the video freezes. Then, all at the same time, the cutouts grow, get closer, and lean towards each other in order to emphasize confrontation. The contrast and saturation is progressively adjusted so the cutouts are highlighted against the background, and the title rolls in so it gets to the center of the screen as the cutout animation stops. This state is held for about 2 seconds, and then the process is reversed. Notice that the animation coincides with the beat of the music. Let's get started with a new 30 frames per second LumaFusion project already containing the video with the subjects Mark and Paula. The project also includes an audio clip with the background music of your choice. Find the point where you want the animation to start. In this case, it is the moment that Mark and Paula turn to face each other. Make a cut. Export a snapshot at the position of the cut to the Photos app. Import the snapshot that you just exported and place it where you made the cut. This will cause the video to freeze at the time of the cut. Identify the points in the music where you want the animation to start and end. Keep in mind that the animation should stay on the screen for no longer than 3 seconds. Align the starting point of the music that you identified with the beginning of the snapshot that you just imported. Adjust the duration of the snapshot so it ends at the point in the music that you identified as the ending point. This is how it looks so far. The next step is to create the cutouts of the characters. For that, we'll use the cutout functionality that was added to Photos with iOS 16 and iPadOS 16. Go to the Photos app, find the snapshot that you exported earlier, and lift the subjects from the background. Notice that both subjects are being lifted together. Now, save the selected cutout to Photos. Import the cutout to LumaFusion. As you can see, the background of the cutout is transparent. Place the cutout above the snapshot that you imported earlier. Change the duration of the cutout so it matches the duration of the snapshot below it. In some cases, the size of the subjects in the cutout and in the snapshot won't be the same. Resize the cutout so its size matches the size of the snapshot below it. The big advantage of the functionality of lifting a subject from the background is that the masking is done for you. As you could see, the disadvantage is that there is also cropping involved in the process, and you may need to resize the cutout to match the original size. The cutouts for Mark and Paula will be animated separately because they will be getting closer and leaning towards each other. For that reason, you'll need to isolate them in different clips and tracks. Crop the cutout so only Mark is visible. Exit back to the timeline. Duplicate the cutout. it will be automatically placed on the third track. Edit the duplicate and change the cropping settings so now only Paula is visible. Exit back to the timeline. Cropping to isolate the subjects in the video worked in this case because there is a vertical gap between the subjects. If the subjects would overlap, like in this case, you'd have to isolate them in photos, one subject at a time, by manually painting over the subject that you want to exclude, and then lift them from the background one at a time. The end result is the same. You end up with two cutouts in LumaFusion. Now, let's create the full animation for Mark. Start by editing his cutout. Expand size and position. Make sure that you are at the beginning of the clip. And add a keyframe. Advance 5 frames. Increase size a bit. A keyframe will be automatically created. Adjust rotation so now Mark slightly leans towards Paula. Now reposition Mark's cutout so it is closer to Paula's. Run the animation frame by frame and make sure that throughout the animation the cutout fully obscures the original subject in the track below it. Now, manually add one additional keyframe 5 frames before the end of the clip, so the position of the cutout remains unchanged for about 2 seconds. Finally, add a keyframe at the end of the clip that reverts the cutout to its original position. So this is how it looks so far. Now, let's progressively adjust levels, contrast, and saturation so the cutout is highlighted against the background. Add the original preset. Make sure that you are at the beginning of the clip and add a keyframe. Advance 5 frames. Adjust the preset as shown. A keyframe will be automatically created. As you can see, the color adjustments coincide with the size and position changes. Now, manually add one additional keyframe 5 frames before the end of the clip, so the color setting of the cutout remains unchanged for about 2 seconds. Finally, add a keyframe at the end of the clip that reverts the cutout to its original color settings. This is how it looks now. Exit back to the timeline. Now, go through the same process for Paula's cutout. This is how it looks after the process is completed. Now, let's add some final touches. A title of your choice with an animation of your choice that coincides with the cutout's animations. Sound effects when the animation starts and ends. And fade in and out for the video and audio. And we're done. This is how it looks all together. Check the names in the credits and let me know what you think. We'll be right back. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you're notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you on the next one.